You see, the Gospel of Barnabas, it mentions our Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam by name. That Isa alayhi salam, Jesus Christ, he prophesied about the coming of another messenger whose name will be Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But now this book is not recognized by the bulk of Christendom. They say it's a forgery. They say this is not authentic. Now, the Muslim is wasting his time. Because Allah commands us to demand proof by asking the Christian or the Jew or whoever, kul hatu burhanakum. Produce your proof. And they have produced the proof, the Bible. Nobody produced Barnabas to you, did they? No. So talk about what is proof, what he is claiming to be true, talk about that. And once you do that, get these booklets of mine, you won't need Barnabas. These booklets will do the job with his Burhan.
The sister asked me the question that I have not mentioned about the Gospel of Barnabas. Why? Is it that it's not authentic? Sister, Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 111, it says that all those who say, they boast, that you shall never enter Jannah unless you be a Jew or a Christian. وَقَالُوا لَيَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ إِلَّا مَنْ كَانَا هُودًا وَنَصَارَى. They say, the Jews and Christian, that you Muslims, you shall never enter Jannah unless you be a Jew or a Christian. Allah says, تِلْكَ أَمَانِيُّهُمْ. This is the wishful thinking, بَقْوَاسِ بَقْوَاسِ, vain desires. Kul, tell them, هَاتُوا بُرْهَانَكُمْ, produce your proof, إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ, but if you're truthful. Allah says, when anyone makes tall claims that you shall not enter Jannah, tell them, قُلْ هَاتُوا بُرْهَانَكُمْ, produce your proof, إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ, but if you're truthful. Now the Christians, they have produced their proof as the Bible. You have to ask them for their proof. You cannot say this is your proof. Let them produce the proof. And the Christian as a whole, they do not consider Gospel of Barnabas to be authentic. Though I do agree Gospel of Barnabas is more closer to the Islamic viewpoint as compared to the other Gospel of Matthew, Mark, Luke and John. But since they don't consider it authentic, and when we can prove our point that there is only one God from these four Gospels, when we can prove our point that Jesus is not God, peace be upon him, from these four Gospels, when we can prove our point that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was not crucified, from the present Bible, so why should we go after Gospel of Barnabas? If you want to read Gospel of Barnabas for academic purposes, alhamdulillah. But I never use it as an argument to the Christian, because first I'll have to have a debate with them that Gospel of Barnabas is true. At the end of 5 years, they may not agree. At the end of 5 hours, the Christian may not agree. So why should I waste my time? When I can prove my point, the Islamic viewpoint, from the present Bible which they are holding, which they say is the word of God, the present four Gospels which they believe in, so why should I go for Gospel of Barnabas? Reading for academic purposes, it is good. But while doing Dawah, I feel you should keep the Gospel of Barnabas out, because the Christians don't consider that to be authentic or to be the word of God. Hope that answers the question.